Welcome to the fifth video of Quantum Mechanics Done Right, The Shortest Path from Novice to Researcher. This is a book that is forthcoming from Springer in 2025. Our first chapter is on the Stern-Gerlach experiment. You can see on the left Otto Stern and on the right Walter Gerlach, and a schematic of what the Stern-Gerlach experiment does is to the far right. What this experiment does is it finds a very clever way of taking atoms that have some net magnetic behavior to them and separating them according to the precise orientation of the little magnets that are present on the atoms. It is remarkable that you can do this, and in many textbooks, they just kind of jump right to the punch and say, you learned in electrodynamics that this is the way magnets feel. Behave in inhomogeneous magnetic fields. Well, most of us don't remember any of this. In fact, most of us never even got to that chapter in an electromagnetism course. It's very complicated behavior, and in this first chapter, we carefully go through exactly how that works, even if you've never taken an electromagnetics or electrodynamics course. You just need a high school preparation, and you can understand everything that we're going to talk about. So chapter one is called Introduction to the Quantum World. Here is an image of that Stern-Gerlach apparatus. This is the first apparatus to measure the spin of the electron. It was not known that that was what it was measuring at the time. You can find many, many very good YouTube videos that will talk about that history. I don't talk about that history very much, but it is nice to see what the initial apparatus actually looked like. And as I mentioned, the behavior of magnets and current loops in inhomogeneous magnetic fields is very complicated. So we take essentially an entire chapter to describe how that works in detail. We then show what you would expect to get from a classical Stern-Gerlach experiment, and then we show you what the quantum result is, and it's very surprising. And the only way that you can understand that result is by bringing in a probabilistic viewpoint. So we develop how you calculate and work with probabilities as part of the chapter as well. And then finally, we do a series of experiments that show that the quantum experiments are reproducible, but that the spin can only be measured on one axis at a time. And this is, again, a really important concept for you to understand as you're starting to learn about what is happening in the quantum world. All right, so let's go ahead and browse through the chapter. We're going to start here in the Introduction to the Quantum World, and you can see our first player here is Steve Martin. That is right, I put Steve Martin as the first image in my book. It's because of a really wonderful comedy routine he had about getting small, and of course in quantum mechanics everything is about getting small. I then will explain to you why both of these images, which you probably did in your elementary school, are really bad images of what an atom looks like. And then we'll just dive into how a classical Stern-Gerlach experiment works. We have this wonderful paradigm that was invented by Daniel Steyer about how we can think of inhomogeneous magnetic fields by using fat arrows. We use that to describe how magnets work and what kind of forces magnets will feel. And then we move into talking about current loops. These were discovered by Oersted. And a current loop behaves a bit like a magnet, but it has some behavior that's a little bit different. It requires us to understand what precession is, so we'll tell you about how precession works. And then we're going to talk about these Stern-Gerlach experiments. If you remember the tutorial demonstration, you can see these are images taken from that tutorial. Of course, the tutorial itself is also great to work through. And here we're showing how this works, what a classical result will give us. And you might have noticed some of these things are highlighted in blue. So if you click on this, it will actually take you to the video on YouTube that describes the classical Stern-Gerlach experiment. If you click on this, it will take you to that tutorial animation that I told you about. And if you have the print version of the book, here's a tiny URL that you can use that will allow you to directly access the website as well. So, of course, we have problems associated with the work that we're developing. We then get into the quantum realm. We talk about the quantum experiment itself, show what the results are. And for those of you that know, you only get two results, not that spread out pattern. And we illustrate a number of different experiments that show that this is repeatable. And they show that you can only know what the projection is on one axis at any given time. And after going through a number of these different experiments, there really are quite a few, we recognize that we have to describe things probabilistically. So we use this fundamental definition of what probability is to teach probability and tell you all about how probability works. We give a number of examples, and we go through further and explain to you some really quite complicated probability ideas that really get you to understand the concept well. And then once you're finished with all of this work on probability, we're ready to really focus on what is happening in the quantum world with the quantum experiments. We look at what happens when you prepare a state on one axis and measure it on another axis. And that is part of what is called a rotating Stern-Gerlach analyzer. This is an invention by Daniel Steyer that helps us do Bell experiments, which are going to be something that we're going to focus on in a later chapter. In fact, it's in the next chapter. And that takes us through what is in chapter one. So guys, let's do quantum right.